Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn how to write a formal letter based on a given situation. The formal letter is official and has professional use. Style of writing is clear and formal. Business letter either for placing orders or inquiry, editorial letter, job application letter all comes under this type of letter. Formal letter must be short and it should be to the point. So we have already learned how to write a letter to the editor, and today we will learn how to write a letter placing order, an inquiry letter, and a letter of complaint. Okay, students. So copy down these examples in your notebook. So the format: first, address of the writer, then date, then name and designation of the addressee, address of the addressee, greeting or salutation, subject. The body part of the letter having the main message or content of the letter, 3 paragraphs. Conclusion, complimentary clause, the name of the center and designation of the center. So this is the common format for all the formal letters. Okay, students. So be thorough with this format and don't commit any mistake in this format. Then you will lose 1 mark in your board exam. Okay, students. As you know, your formal letter is of 5 marks. So be very thorough and sure with the format. So children, we will be learning how to write this formal letters based on any given situation through examples. So children, copy down this example questions in your notebook, and there is practice question also for each kind. So try to do that practice question and send the answer to me. And those who haven't submitted the English portfolio activity, submit it this week itself. You are making a big delay in submitting the English portfolio activity on the picture album on the Glimpses of India. Okay, children? Yes. So we are moving forward to the examples of the various formal letters. So I hope the letter to the editor is thorough with you, as we have learned it in the earlier phase itself. So children, you have to leave a line after each section. Like after writing the address of the writer, you have to leave a line and write the date likewise. So the formal letters are inquiry letter, complaint letter, letter placing an order, and letter to the editor. This job application letter you will learn when you are in class 12. Okay, children? Yes. So first let's learn how to write a complaint letter. A complaint letter is a type of letter written to address any type of wrongdoing, offense, grievance, resentment arising out of a product, service, etc. Raise your concern about unfair things and seek a productive outcome. Fundamental right. Write a letter to Ms. Manufacturers of Oxford Publishing House, London, complaining that the books sent by them were not those you had ordered for. Ask for replacement. You are Varun Joshi, Sector 20, Chandigarh. Okay, children. So we are writing a complaint letter to the. So children, you have to write a letter of complaint because you have got the books that you hadn't ordered for. And you are writing this complaint letter to the Oxford Publishing House, okay? The manufacturers. Then you can, in the address, you can mention whether the manager and all those things, okay? Now, first you have to give your address, then leave a line, then write the date, then again leave a line, and then write the manager, to the manager or the executive officer. Likewise, you can give the designation. And the address part is given in the question itself, Oxford Publishing House, Consumer Complaint Division, London. Okay, children. So, this is the first step. You have to write the address of the writer, then write the date, then the address to which you have to send this letter. So, all these basic details will be given in the question itself. You should just pick it up and write it. Now, the main content will be split into 3 paragraphs. First, subject. Complaint regarding receipt of wrong set of books. The subject should be very brief. Sir or Madam, On May 1st, 2020, I bought a book set, order number you should mention, to be delivered to Chandigarh, Sector 20. To my dismay, I have not received the set I ordered for and have instead received the wrong book set. I am highly disappointed. That's the first paragraph. Now we are detailing your problem. To resolve the problem, I would appreciate it if you could replace the wrong book set with the one originally ordered. Please let me know as soon as possible what action you propose to take. So that forms the second paragraph. Okay, you want the books to be replaced. In the first paragraph, you are introducing the problem. Then you are offering what solution, what remedy you accept from them. So this is the specialty of this complaint letter. Okay, children. So the presentation of the things matter. When you write a complaint letter, in the first paragraph of the content, you have to introduce your problem. You have to just state your complaint. Then the second paragraph, you have to mention what remedy, okay, what solution you want them to give to you. Okay, so this is it. A very brief way you have to write. So as it's a 5-mark question, the content should form one page. Okay, children, the content should be one page. I'm not telling about the address part and all those things. The content itself, it should make one page. Okay, so keep that in your mind. So you have to mention the order number. That is very necessary when you report about a complaint, and or the date on which you received that product. All those things should be clearly mentioned when you go for a complaint letter. And the most important thing is that from the subject itself, they should get an idea about what the complaint is. So look at the subject here, complaint regarding receipt of wrong set of books. Okay, very clear title, very clear subject had been given. So you have to mention it very clearly. Enclosed are copies of the transaction document and the receipt. I look forward to your reply and a resolution to my problem. Please contact me at the above address or by phone at, there's a phone number given, then yours truly, Varun Joshi. Okay, children, you have to enclose the copies of the transaction document, the invoice, the bill and the receipt and all. And you have to conclude by saying that you are looking forward to a reply and a solution to your problem. And you can give even your mail address or the contact number, asking them to contact you at the earliest. So this is the way you should write your letter of complaint. As I have told you, the content should be rich. It should be at 3 paragraphs and you should write it in one page itself. Okay, children. One page should form the content part. And you can even give a fake number. No need to give your exact phone number and all. For the sake of just giving the phone number, you can state it. Okay, children. Yes. So remember all these points. There is only a minute change for the other formal letters. Now you can have a question for practice. Write a letter to the manufacturers of HMT Corporation Chandigarh complaining that the wristwatch you recently bought from them does not function properly and ask for replacement. You are Deepthi or Deepak Gupta, 450 Sector 20 Chandigarh. Do it and send me. Now next we are moving on to inquiry letter. How to write a letter of inquiry. Okay, inquiry means you are asking for some information. Inquiry letter is a letter asking for some information. So children, next you are going to write the letter of inquiry. So it, the format is the same. First you have to write the address of the center, then give the date. Then you have to write the address of the receiver. The director, National Science Center, Anand Vihar, Lucknow. Okay, children, so let's see how to write a letter of inquiry. As I have already mentioned, a letter of inquiry, you're asking about some information. Okay, children, so the format is the same for all the formal letters. Only the content part differs. So you should learn those differences that forms the content part of these various formal letters. Okay, children. So, whenever you are asked a letter of inquiry, it is about seeking information. And you have to inquire about a lot of things when you write a letter of inquiry. the possible knowledge you should get about that particular institute. Inquiring to join astronomy club. Sir, this is with reference to the astronomy club that is going to be started by National Science Center in Lucknow in a fortnight. I wish to join the club. I am Sanket, a student of Vidyanchali Public School, Lucknow, studying in 10th class. I have a very keen interest in astronomy. I wish to join ISRO when I grow up. I have returned to your esteemed self to know a few details of the club as mentioned below. Okay, children, so whenever you write an inquiry letter, you have to list the things that you want to know about. Okay, so here somebody wants to join astronomy club and you are inquiring how to join the process and all those things. So in the first paragraph, you are introducing yourself and just giving a plain statement of that what is the purpose of your letter. So in the first paragraph, you are just writing the purpose of your letter, why you are writing a letter, what is the intention behind writing a letter. So all those details that you want to know should be listed. Okay, children, all the details that you want to know should be listed in bullet points. So first one is venue, then duration, then fee structure, activities, transportation. So you have to either number it or write it as bullet points one by one. That will attract the attention of your invigilator. Now in the concluding paragraph, I shall be exceedingly grateful if you provide me with the above mentioned details so that I can do the formalities to join the club. Looking forward to your prompt response. Okay, how you have to write the concluding paragraph, children? You have to express your gratitude for providing. Okay, already you are expressing your gratitude for providing the details and so that you can do the formalities to join the club, and you are looking forward to a prompt response. Then yours truly, Samkit. You can use yours truly, yours faithfully, and yours sincerely. All those things are very standardized uses. Now let's see the practice question. You are Reema or Rajesh, D10, Lajpat Nagar, New Delhi. You want information about German language courses at the German Embassy, Chanakyapuri, New Delhi. Write a letter of inquiry. Okay, try to do that question, children. Now, next we are going to learn letter placing an order. How to write a formal letter placing an order. It's a very commonly asked formal letter. Okay, children. So, when you write a letter placing order, the format remains the same. First, the address of the sender, then date, then the address of the receiver. So, what all things you want to order, that you have to form a table, a tabular column. Subject, purchase of sports items. Dear sir, our school wishes to place an order for sports items in bulk with your company. These items will be used in the activities room, gym and sports ground of the school starting from the academic session 2020-21. The list of the items along with their quantity is given below. Okay, so first you are stating your purpose, you are introducing yourself as well, and then you are providing the list of the items. You are placing the order, okay, that items, their quantity, number, everything in the second paragraph. And it is always in a tabular form. Name of the item, quantity. Okay, children, football 6, cricket bats 12, hockey sticks 30, gloves 20 pairs, tennis balls 10. So, make sure that in the second paragraph, you are making it a tabular column. You mention the name of the item you want and the quantity also. Don't forget to mention the quantity. So, the second column, you have informed them about the order. Okay, what all things you want to purchase. Now, the third paragraph. Kindly deliver the order on time by ensuring that all the items are taken from the fresh lot. Payment of the entire purchase will be done digitally once we receive the goods. It would be great if you could share the time when all the items will be delivered at our address. Okay, so in the third paragraph, you are expecting your purchase at early. Okay, you expect to get those things at the earliest, and you ensure that the payment will be done once you receive it. Looking forward to hear from you. Yours truly, Ankit, sports in charge. You can mention your designation when you write such a letter. Okay, children. So that is the common conclusion that you have for the letter placing order as such. Okay, children. So you have to mention whether you are having any particular designation as mentioned in the question. Okay, so read the question thoroughly and pick out all the details given from the question. And you have to design the letter likewise. Now let's see the practice question. Write a letter to the sales manager, MMS Books, Ashok Vihar, Delhi, placing order for 5 titles of books that you need for educational purpose. You are Sanjeev or Sanjana, Model Town, Kurukshetra. Okay, children, so try to do this question and send me the answer. I hope you are clear with these formal letters of inquiry, complaint and placing order. So if you have any doubts, do clarify it with me in the live session. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day.